Hello there, my fellow battle brothers, and welcome to your weekly dose of Space Marine Chapters lore. For today, I wanted to take a short break from the Tier 2 longer chapters and cover once again, in many weeks for a change, one of the so-called Tier 3 chapters. If you are unfamiliar with this terminology, basically a Tier 2 chapter is one taking 2 or 3 or even 4 videos to fully cover, while a Tier 3 chapter is one that I can do in a single video. Today's chapter is one that I presented to you before in multiple polls, but it never got enough votes, so I'm gonna do it justice today. They are the one and only Iron Snakes chapter. I am your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us learn more about them, shall we? The Iron Snakes is a second founding Ultramarines Primogenitor successor chapter. It was created in the second founding using the gene seed of the Primarch Robot Gilliman. Unusually for a chapter of such esteemed lineage, however, the Iron Snakes are not a Codex Astartes compliant chapter in their tactics or organization. The current chapter master, Sadon, is the 18th to bear the title since the foundation of the chapter. The first squad leaders of the chapter have been immortalized within its ranks, as their names have been retained as the official designation of the squads they first led. Every squad in the chapter is known by the name of its first commanding sergeant, and careful attention is paid to recording the deeds of each squad and the glory it has accumulated. Over the centuries, several squads judged to have accumulated particularly impressive and glorious histories are now referred to as notable squads, and are seen as the preeminent units in the entire chapter, the closest formation that exists to a true veteran unit. There are 5 notable squads within the Iron Snakes: the Scipio, Parphas, Veii, Thebes, and Damocles squads. Scipio squad is the senior squad of the entire chapter, and is the closest thing to a conventional elite unit that the Iron Snakes possess. While the nominal fighting strength of the chapter, or Fratry as it is referred to by the Iron Snakes themselves, is kept at the Codex Astartes approved 1000 Space Marines, but the Iron Snakes do not appear to use the Codex's prescribed company structure, instead basing its organization around that of the simple 10-man squad rather than the 100-man company. Every squad, named after its first squad leader, is treated as an individual tactical formation, held equal in the line of battle, with almost all the other Fratry units. Only those squads referred to as the Notables are seen as the elite of the chapter, and even these Notables do not properly represent a pool of veteran Space Marines, as in the first companies of many other chapters. This is due to the way that the Iron Snakes field their new initiates. Recruits, referred to as petitioners within the chapter, do not appear to take to the field as scout marines like the neophytes in other chapters. Instead, they operate as chapter staff and personal servants to the full battle brothers. When casualties incurred require the elevation of petitioners to the rank of full Space Marines, the petitioners try out for the positions by engaging their potential squadmates in single combat competition. The winners of these competitions, or those judged particularly skillful by the squad sergeant, are chosen to become full battle brothers and fratry members. Places in the notable squads are competed for in the same way as the other squads, which means that the notables are just as likely to have petitioners in their ranks as they are to have hardened veteran Space Marines. Of course, the petitioners that manage to win a place in a notable squad are very likely to be the best in their generation. When a squad is completely wiped out, it is reconstituted under the original name, with the new sergeant being promoted from the ranks of the elder and more veteran Space Marines of the other squads. Every squad leader is expected to eventually nominate a successor from his own squad, who will be chosen to accompany him to the officer-level briefings and take command of the squad in the event of his death. This Astartes will likely remain tied to the squad until his very own death, as such seconds are not promoted out to command other squads. Every squad will also contain a standard bearer, who fixes the squad's colors to a special mounting upon his armor, and a support weapons trooper, with the plasma gun and flamer appearing to be the favorite in chapter support weapons. The notable squads also appear to customarily include an apothecary as one of their number, and such specialist space marines are a common feature of other Iron Snake squads as well. The number of field apothecaries in the Iron Snakes appears likely to be higher than that of a fully Codex Astartes compliant chapter. The Iron Snakes recruit their neophytes from the world of Ithaca, an imperial ocean world, commonly referred to by its people as the Cradle of Snakes, which is largely covered in very deep oceans and home to a variety of sea life, including the great serpentine water worms. Ithaca does possess significant landmasses too, including tropical islands and viciously cold polar regions. The Iron Snakes are therefore able to train in a variety of environments, although the sea is most precious to them. A Kraretiker, or mature male waterworm, is known to grow up to 300 meters in length. The chapter uses these worms in hunting exercises for its initiates, and in the ritual punishment known as Othanar. The water worms are known to cause Retiarion, or Wormstorm, ferocious squalls that seem to follow the movement of the marine serpent. A Retiarion eventually cause Tsunane, the folding walls of iron, which are giant tsunamis that rise out of the deep waters and come crashing into the settled islands while standing kilometers high. Their actual fortress monastery, which they refer to as the Chapter House, is located on Ithaca's fortress moon of Charybdis, and features a great bell as large as a space marine drop pod. The Chapter House is a mighty bastion with sloped turrets lined with earthshaker cannons, massive curtain walls, and hardpoint blisters of Hydra batteries. It contains armories, forges, training halls, a chapel, and an apothecarium. It also contains a main pool of water known as the Hall of the Balneary. The balneary is a 50-meter square filled with sacred seawater imported from Ithaca itself. The so-called Tholos lies beneath the Chapter House, anchored deep in the rocky crust of Charybdis. This is a stockade for the Astartes of the Iron Snakes that is seldom used due to the meticulous discipline of the chapter. Its most common residents are prisoners of war, however, held pending interrogation under the watchful eyes of the veteran Astartes known as the Archons. The Iron Snakes were stationed in the sector of Imperial space known as the Reef Stars, and charged with its protection as their main mission many thousands of years ago. The inhabited worlds of the Reef, while varied in their level of technological development, were each given a form of technology to summon the Iron Snakes that was ritualized into their society. The Iron Snakes are a myth or a legend on some worlds, and an awe-inspiring reality on others. Regardless of how they are viewed, the Snakes of Ithaca take their duty to the Reef Stars very seriously, and will go to any lengths possible to protect the sector and its citizens. The actions they have fought in the Reef Stars are many, as the entire area appears to be under constant threat by the Dark Eldar raiders. As a result, the Iron Snakes have amassed considerable experience fighting the Dark Eldar, who they, and the people of the Reef Stars, also refer to as Primules, a word for these Xenos derived from an ancient dialect. The Iron Snakes also fought a 10-year war against a large orc invasion. These orc forces, made up of multiple Waz, were so large that it was impossible for the Iron Snakes to combat them in the traditional way. However, having managed to secure an important relic to the orcs, the Iron Snakes were then able to draw the Orc forces out of the Rift Stars, and into unclaimed Xenos territory. The remainder of the Orcs were then expunged, and the Rift Stars were judged greenskin-free for more than 1,000 years now. When a mission, referred to within the chapter as an undertaking, is decided upon, the chapter master announces how many squads he believes are required to ensure its success. All squad leaders who wish to volunteer their units to the mission then place a token into a kylix, which is a form of drinking cup whose origins lie supposedly in ancient Greece on Terra. The chapter master then decides which squads to assign to the undertaking based upon the tokens he finds in the kylix. While the squad is the principal tactical unit of the chapter, sometimes even less manpower is required. In cases of responding to general aid requests from the worlds of the Rift Stars, it is customary to deploy only one battle brother from the closest squad to investigate. The chosen Astartes is often either the newest member of the squad, or a member considered for the role of successor by the squad leader. A one-person undertaking is seen as a fitting challenge for such space marines. Historically, a single warrior is usually enough in cases of general aid request, though it is no shame for the individual to request the presence of his brothers once apprised of the specific situation. Though the Iron Snakes are able to deploy an acceptable number of vehicles, which also include dreadnoughts and librarians among their forces, the primacy of the combat squad means that they concentrate on basic infantry tactics in battle. The chapter's armory is able to issue combat shields, war blades or short power swords, and sea lances, which are javelin-type fighting spears, commonly referred to as Astartes power spears, to all the battle brothers, enabling them to close up and use the phalanx or shield wall tactics. They are particularly skillful with the sea lance, as part of a petitioner's training on their homeworld of Ithaca involves the hunting and slaying of the large predaceous water worms native to the planet. Every Iron Snake is issued with 2 sea lances before battle to be used and disposed of, and fratry battle brothers are issued fresh lances before the next engagement. The Iron Snakes are a meticulously disciplined chapter, though they do deviate significantly from the Codex Astartes. The water from Ithaca's oceans is considered sacred by its people, and when the Iron Snakes' battle brothers are called to go to war on a distant planet, they perform one last act before leaving, a ceremony known as the Rite of the Claiming of Water. This water is carried in a copper flask by every battle brother to anoint every planet that they set foot upon in another ritual ceremony called the Rite of the Giving of Water. When these battle brothers return to their homeworld, the remaining water in those vials is given back to the oceans of Ithaca in a ritual known as the Rite of Returning. The cremated remains of those Iron Snakes Astartes killed in battle are also returned in ceremonial copper urns known as Eusippus. Usually the senior-most battle brother in the squad of the deceased performs this last sacred duty. As the Lament of Dicey is intoned, the lid of each urn is unscrewed in turn, and the grey ash is shaken out. The remains of the fallen are sieved away into the wind and returned like the water to the sea. The fallen Astartes squad leader carries prepared statements written on a scroll of paper about the valiant dead's life, actions, and death, sealed and ready to be placed within the archives of the chapter house. Often these scrolls also contain full orders of merit, laying out the full details and particulars of an Iron Snake Space Marine service with the chapter, as well as all the commendations and decorations he has earned. Another common practice of the Iron Snakes is a ritual punishment used against those Astartes who have committed a terrible crime, known as Ofanar, or Trial by Worm. The accused is left alone and unarmed on a stilt rock, forced to face the worms as they are summoned. If the accused man is still alive at the end of 6 hours, he is considered guilty of the charges against him. The people of Ithaca believe that the water worms will not defile themselves by touching a guilty man. If they take the accused, he is one of Ithaca's chosen children, and his innocence will be celebrated in funeral songs and grief rites. Either way, you're entirely screwed. The Iron Snake's power armor is painted gunmetal gray with a golden aquila. Their shoulder plates are trimmed in red as a standard color scheme, but otherwise are painted in the hues of the chapter's varying squad colors. The blue squad specialty symbol, Assault, Tactical, Devastator, or Veteran, is indicated on the right shoulder guard, with a white Roman numeral indicating squad number stenciled in white in the center of it. Company designation is displayed as a blue Roman numeral on the white left knee plate. If a veteran, this knee plate would instead be red with a white skull. Their chapter badge is a coiled blue snake on a white background. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about the Iron Snakes chapter for today. Another ancient Greek-style chapter with the legend of Odysseus as the theme this time. At least they're not asshole ancient Greeks like the Minotaurs. Are the Iron Snakes among your favorite Space Marine chapters? What do you like most about them? Let us know and discuss in the comments below. Was this episode informative or entertaining? In that case, please click the like button and subscribe for future content. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all an awesome day. The Emperor protects.